Hi guys, this is the second part of my line project. What I want you guys to do is last week we talked about the art element line, how there's different types of line, and we did a grid. We created different designs using line. So I want to go ahead and do a landscape, and this landscape is going to have line, okay? So you choose your own landscape. You do not have to copy me, okay? So, in fact, I don't want you to copy me. You could do a tropical scene, you could do a snow scene, you could do any kind of landscape you want. And of course, a landscape is a picture or a drawing of the land, okay? So I'm starting with some rocks in the front. Now, this is simplified, okay? So it's gonna be a little slightly abstracted, but it's gonna be simplified. Okay, so I'm just doing some zigzags now, right? For grass. Now I'm gonna do a tree, I think. We need a focal point. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do a tree. Just two parallel lines and kind of goes out at the bottom, right? Okay, so the same thing with the top. You just kind of want to do a few branches. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna simplify the outside. So basically I'm just gonna do this. And we're gonna fill that in with different lines, you'll see later, okay? So from here, I think I'm just gonna add some hills. Okay, so maybe this tree's up kind of on a hill. In the back, you always wanna think about what's behind. Okay, and then maybe down here, we've got, this could possibly be some water in here. Back, you always wanna think about what's behind. Okay, and then maybe down here, we've got, this could possibly be some water in here. Okay, and then behind, we could have a mountain or a hill. It looks like I'm filling the page. Right here is a great place. I'm gonna put a sun. I usually don't tell you guys to put a sun, but we're gonna stylize it. I'm gonna stylize it. I don't like suns in the corner, but if it's stylized, that's different. And we've talked about that in class before. Okay, that's it. And I'm gonna use colored marker to add my lines. So I'm keeping my lines kind of close together, so then that way you'll have plenty of color. If they're too far apart, then later on you're not gonna see much color. It won't look as dynamic. So for my grass, I'm going to do the background yellow because I think I want my grass to be really bright. So I'm gonna do yellow and then add some green design and line on top. And remember, this is kind of abstracted. This is not how the real grass would look, is it? We're just getting creative with line. This project will take you some time. It won't be quite as successful if you rush. So if you need to do this in a couple different time periods where you're getting tired, you may need to do that and just take your time and get back after it later. Work for a little bit and then come back. If you start getting tired, usually it starts to get messy. On this hill, I started adding some spiral lines just to have something different. Okay, so I finished my orange spirals, and I'm just gonna go in and add, I don't know, something else. Fill in some of the white spaces, just a little bit of maybe this peach color. So I'm keeping with the same color family, pretty much. This peach is gonna blend slightly with the orange. If we have too much contrast in one area, what'll happen is that the whole composition will start to look messy. So you wanna try and keep it to the same color family, I think. If you do too many colors, it might just be kinda crazy. It could be really cool, but it could also look a little wild, and you might not see the different parts as well. So I'm just gonna finish coloring in a little bit. I'm just putting dots here and there just to fill the white space. Okay, so I got that hill done. I'm kind of planning this out in my head. I know I have green here, and I know there's gonna be green here. So I definitely didn't want to do a green hill here. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this with some green. Maybe I'll find another green. Don't forget you don't want to leave too much white showing all the way up to the edge. You want to go all the way to the edge of whatever you're doing. Maybe a continuous line. Sometimes those are challenging. I'm gonna move on and maybe do the water. And I'm gonna do the water blue. I'm gonna use the obvious thing and just do wavy lines for the water. Some zigzags. Now remember, you wanna fill the space, so they need to be close to each other. And I'm gonna fill these in and probably just put some dots. And then the background, I'm gonna keep it very simple, the sky. I'm just gonna do straight lines. Now your pattern should all look different from mine, your designs, and your color choices. You can use mine for ideas, but you should try and come up with your own patterns and designs using different types of lines. That's it. Hope you enjoyed that activity online.